गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द सेशन ऑफ एपी जीपी एंड एचपी। दैट इज बेसिकली डील्स विद अर्थमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन, ज्योमेट्रिक प्रोग्रेशन एंड हार्मोनिक प्रोग्रेशन। इट्स ए पार्ट ऑफ एलजब्रा एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम कैट पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू एज वेल एज फॉर अदर एग्जामिनेशन, स्नैप, जैक्ट। नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चन आर बीइंग आस्क्ड फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक एंड नंबर ऑफ शॉर्टकट मेथड्स आर ऑल्सो प्रेवलेंट इन दिस टॉपिक्स, सो दैट the question could be done in a very simple way. Let us start with a chapter, that is sequence and series. In this chapter we are going to understand three progressions, AP, GP and HP. First, I am going to start with a comparative study between AP, GP and HP so that you can easily understand the basic formulas are required and where is the difference between AP, GP and HP. The term AP stands for arithmetic progression. That stands for arithmetic progression. GP stands for geometric progression. HP stands for harmonic progression. Okay. Suppose if I say 1, 5, 9, 13, 17 and so on. 2, 8, 14, 20, so on. 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, so on. 2, 6, 18, 54, so on. 1 upon 3, 1 upon 5, 1 upon 7, 1 upon 9, right? 1 upon 13, 1 upon 17, 1 upon 21, 1 upon 25, so on, right? Here I have stated you the 6 series. When we try to understand the first series, here I can say that my first term is 1, second term is 5, then 9. If I find the common difference, what is the difference between 5 and 4? That is 1. What is the difference between 9 and 5? That is 4. 13 and 9, that is 4. 17 and 13, that is 4. The difference between 8 and 2 is 6. 14 and 8 is 6. 20 and 14 is 6. Here I can say common difference in two consecutive terms is equal, right? It means this series is known as arithmetic progression. The first definition is where common difference in the two consecutive terms is same, that is said to be AP series. When I talk about the second series, 1, 2, 4, 8, 16. 1 into 2, 2 means 2 by 1, 2, 4 by 2, 2, 8 by 4, 2, 16 by 8, 2 means common ratio. 6 by 2, 3, 18 by 6, 3, 54 upon 18, 3. So here I can say that common ratio in two consecutive terms is same. So I can say this series is known as geometric progression. Then we have the third series, that is harmonic progression. Harmonic means if I make a reverse of AP, suppose 1 by 3, 1 by 5, 1 by 7. If I make the reverse of my first term, I get 3. Here I get 5, 7 and 9. This series is in AP. It means that sequence is harmonic progression. What we can say, any series is said to be in harmonic progression where reciprocal of the terms, where reciprocal of terms are in AP. So we can say that the series are in harmonic progression. I hope the idea is clear. Now with the first step, we are just in a position to understand what do you mean by the AP series, what do you mean by the GP series and what do you mean by the HP series. Okay. Now after that, I am going to start with the basic formulas. Suppose in AP series, the terms that we use, A stands for the first term. Then we use D. D stands for common difference. D stands for common difference. And TN is used for nth term. TN is used for nth term. Suppose if I have to find T2. T2 means I have to find the second term, right? Then N must be 2. The first formula for finding the TN term is A plus N minus 1 into D. The basic formula for finding TN term is A plus N minus 1 into D. If you have to find the sum of the N terms, your formula will be N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. If you have to find the sum of the N terms, your formula is N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. Or we may also infer here that is N by 2 into A plus L. Right, where L is said to be the last term. But we can say that now in this we have understood these three formulas. The first is for finding the Tn term, that is a plus n minus 1 into d. Then Sn term, sum of the n terms, that is said to be n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Then we may also have one more formula for that, that it is n by 2 into a plus l, first term plus last term. Okay. Similarly, when we consider GP, in GP, a is said to be first term, r is said to be common ratio. Here we have d, that was common difference. In this we have r, that is said to be common ratio. Then we take Tn term. Tn term is nth term. Here my formula is a into r raised to power n minus 1. For finding the Tn term, our formula is a into r raised to power n minus 1. If you have to find the sum of the n terms of the GP, that is said to be a into r raised to power n minus 1 upon r minus 1. Right? Where modulus of r is greater than 1, or we can say that where value of r is more than 1 or less than minus 1, so there we can say that formula we apply. On the other hand, if r is less than 1, between 1 to minus 1, so we can apply that formula is, that is said to be Sn equal to a into 1 minus r raised to power n upon 1 minus r. Although conceptually both are the same thing, there is not any problem. If I take common from the numerator, I will get the same thing. So here I can say that Sn is said to be a into 1 minus r raised to power n upon 1 minus r. Similarly, when I consider the harmonic progression, in the harmonic progression, although we don't have any standard formula for finding the sum, but finding the Tn term, but we can say that 1 upon a plus n minus 1 into d. Because we know that harmonic progression is the reciprocal of arithmetic progression. Means when we make the reciprocal of term, that becomes arithmetic progression. So there I can say Tn is said to be 1 upon a plus n minus 1 into d. Here we don't have any formula for finding the sum of terms. Why? Because I cannot make an addition of 1 by 3 plus 1 by 5 by making it reverse, and then I just cannot reverse it. Right? These are the basic formulas that we use in arithmetic progression, geometric progression and harmonic progression. Right? After that, I am going to discuss some more basic things in AP-GP which we are trying to understand in a comparison mode. That is geometric progression. The next thing that I am trying to understand here is, it deals with, in an AP series, if you have to assume three terms, that is assumption of terms, the next point here is assumption of terms. Sometime it is given that you have to assume some terms in the series AP or GP. Suppose you have AP series, you have to assume three terms, four terms, or five terms, or so on, right? So when you have to assume three terms in an AP, you may assume it as a plus d, a plus 2d, but the better approach is, you have to take it as a minus d, a and a plus d, right? Similarly, when you have to assume four terms, you assume it as a minus 3d, a minus d, a plus d, a plus 3d. Why you assume it? When you add all these, the d will be cancelled out and you are in a position to have all the expressions in a. Similarly, if you have to assume 5 terms, make it as a minus 2d, a minus d, a plus d, a plus 2d. So that is when you have to assume the 5 terms in an AP, your assumption should be that one, because that makes your question to be simple. On the other hand, when we consider GP, in GP also if you have to assume 3 terms, it should be a upon r, a and ar. Why we are taking this? When the product is given, R will be cancelled out and your sequence would only be in A. Similarly, when 4 terms have to be assumed, it should be AR cube, A upon R, AR and AR cube. Right? Why we have taken this? Because when we multiply all the 4 terms, all R will be cancelled out. Similarly, when we have to assume 5 terms, that would be taken as A upon R square, A upon R, AR, AR square, right? So that we have to assume in a geometric progression when we assume to 5 terms, right? So the next point that we are understand here is, in AP series, your assumption will always be of this type, 3 term, 4 term and 5 term. as well as in GP series, if you have to assume 3 term, 4 term and 5 term, your assumption must always be of this type. Okay? After that, we have a very important property that can also be understood in a comparison mode between arithmetic progression and geometric progression. Suppose an AP series is given, terms are given T1, T2, T3, that goes up to Tn minus 1 and Tn. Right? The property here is the sum of the term equidistant from the middle is always equal. How? T1 plus Tn. Same as to T2 plus Tn minus 1. Same as to T3 plus Tn minus 2. The sum will always be equal. What is the trick that you have to understand here? N plus 1. When you add 2 plus n minus 1, you get it as n plus 1, right? What I can say that T2 plus T8 is same as to T4 plus. What term is there? Apply that. 8 plus 2, 10. Here is 4, it must be 6. It is equal to T6. What you have understood here now, in any arithmetic progression series, the sum of the terms equidistant from the middle is always same. Okay. You may also prove this with the help of your basic formula. T2 is said to be a plus d because our formula is a plus n minus 1 into d. T8 is said to be a plus 7d. My sum would be 2a plus 8d. Right? That's my left hand side. When I take the right hand side, T4. T4 is a plus 3d. T6 is a plus 5d. When I add both, we get it as 2a plus 8d. That is also equal to that one. Right? So what I can say that my left hand side is equal to right hand side, it means my answer is there. So that is arithmetic progression. Similarly, we have one property of this type in geometric progression that is said to be, if you have T1, T2, T3, it goes up to Tn. Okay, here what you can say that in arithmetic progression, I have given you that the sum of the terms equidistant from the middle is same. Here the product of the term is same. How? You may take it as T1 into Tn, T1 into Tn is same as to T2 into Tn minus 1, is same as to T3 into Tn minus 2. Okay, for example, if I say T2 into T8, we have to take the product with T4 into 8 plus 2, 10, it means that is said to be T6. But we can say that the product of T2 into T8 is always equal to T4 into T6 in case of geometric progression. If I say T2, we can just try to prove it. We know that the Tn term for GP is A into R raised to power n minus 1. So I may say T2 is AR, T8 is AR raised to power 7 when we multiply A square into R raised to power 8. That we have take. Similarly, T4 into T6, AR raised to power 3, A r raised to power 5. When you multiply, you get it as A square into R raised to power 8. Here you can say that your answer is same. We can just prove this property also. So these are very important properties. Sometime the questions may be made over this property of AP and GP. Then the next thing we can also understand in the comparison mode here is we have means. Arithmetic means, geometric mean and harmonic mean. Right? How? When I talk about arithmetic mean, arithmetic mean, suppose two terms are there, A and B. Right? When we consider arithmetic mean, that is simply average, we may take it as A plus B by 2. If we say geometrical mean, that is root of AB. Okay? When we say harmonic mean, although the standard formula of harmonic mean is 2ab upon a plus b. The formula that we use is 2ab upon a plus b. But in the next point, I state you how we can take this. Suppose three terms are given. One is a, b and c. You have to find arithmetic mean. It should be average. A plus b plus c upon 3. Okay. And in the case of geometrical mean, your approach is very simple. Make the product of all the three ABC and power should be 1 by 3. means if the terms are 3, you have to make it cube root of abc, or you may take it as abc raised to power 1 by 3. When you have to find the harmonic mean, what process you apply here? In order to find the harmonic mean, first you convert your abc, because they are in hp, as per to the concept, it means 1 upon a, 1 upon b, 1 upon c, they are in ap. Okay, we take the arithmetic mean of that, 1 upon a plus 1 upon b plus 1 upon c upon 3. That gives me ab plus bc plus ca, ab plus bc plus ca upon 3abc. Right? But we have to find the harmonic mean, that is the reverse of it. It becomes 3abc upon ab plus bc plus ca. Right? So what we can say that if you have to find the harmonic mean, in that case, when terms are greater than 2, if they are only 2, you can just cram this, right? If they are greater than 2, in that case, first of all, convert into the AP, then take the arithmetic mean, and after that, you have to reverse that arithmetic mean, and finally, you get your value as 3ABC upon AB plus BC plus CA. Okay, I hope now on that basis, if n terms are there, you may take it as 3ABC upon AB plus BC plus CA. Now if I say if n terms are there, it means if you have to take the arithmetic mean, that is said to be A plus B plus C up to Tn upon n. If you are going to take the geometrical mean, A into B into C up to Tn raised to power 1 by n, right? If you take harmonic mean, you may take it as 1 upon 1 by A plus 1 by B plus 1 by C up to 1 upon Tn upon n. That is said to be harmonic mean, right? I hope from this discussion, you are in a position to understand the association between arithmetic progression, geometric progression and harmonic progression. One property we may also infer from here that in any series of AM, GM and HM, arithmetic progression is always greater than or equal to geometrical progression, and harmonic progression is always less than geometrical progression. Means AM is greater than or equal to GM and GM is greater than or equal to HM. Right? If terms are equal, if terms are same, so we can say that AM equal to GM equal to HM. If terms are same, in that case, we may say that AM is GM is equal to HM. Till in this chapter, we have studied the different formulas for AP, GP and HP. Now after a discussion of the formulas, first of all, we try to solve some questions on AP and GP, some basic questions, so that we are in a position to understand how to apply those concepts, right? Let us start with some different questions here, so that you are in a position to understand. My ratio is said to be 37, ratio 59, that becomes your answer. So I can say that the ratio of two different APs of 19th term is, of 10th term is equal to 37 ratio 59. I hope it's clear, right? On the similar lines, we may solve some different questions over the GP, so that you are in a position to have the concept of the GP in your mind. All the formulas earlier I told you, now I am just going to state you some different questions. The next type of question is geometrical progression is, for example, if I say sum of the three terms of a GP is 31, it is given that sum of three terms of a GP of a geometrical progression is 31, right? Then and sum of their squares and sum of their squares, sum of their squares is equal to 651. We have to find the terms. Okay. Now when we look at this question, let us assume that the three terms are given. We may take the terms to be AR square. The sum is equal to 31. A plus AR plus AR square is equal to 31. then it is given that sum of the square is 651, we may say a square plus a square r square plus a square r raised to power 4, this is equal to 651. Okay, now I have to solve it. If I divide these two, so what I will get, a will be cancelled out, so I may take it as 1 plus r square, and in denominator I may say 1 plus r square plus r raised to power 4, this is equal to 31 upon 651. Okay, now if I just cancel out, that will go on 31 to the 62, and then 31, it will go on 1 upon 21. Okay, now I have to just solve it. If I just try to solve it, what process I am having in the numerator? We have 1 plus r square. In the denominator, we have 1 plus r square plus r raised to power 4. Now what I can say, I just try to make the factorization of this. How? If I add r square in this and subtract r square, so this will be taken as 1 plus r square. In denominator, it becomes at, if I add r square and minus r square, that becomes 1 plus r square whole square minus r square. Right? How? If you open the square, 1 plus r raised to power 4 plus 2 r square, and this is minus r square, when you subtract, you get it as 1 plus r square plus r raised to power 4. That would be further taken as 1 plus r square, and this would be taken as a square minus b square, a plus b into a minus b. So I may take it as 1 plus r square plus r into 1 plus r square minus r. Right? Now this would be cancelled out, or else I can say 1 plus r square minus r equal to 1 upon 21. Right? Now from here I can simplify my value of r, and I am in a position to get my answer, because now I can simply cross multiply. After cross multiplying, I can find the value of r, and if you just solve it, you find that the value of the r is equal to 5, and your numbers are 1, 5 and 25. The answer to your question is 1, 5 and 25. That becomes your answer. Solve it for r. Put the value of r here in the first equation. From here you can get the value of a, and then you can in a position to find out what is your answer. I hope the idea is clear, right? Till time we have understood the basic concepts of AP, GP and HP, the formulas that are required for solving these questions. This is our session number 1. In the next session of AP, GP and HP, I will explain you high level problems, the different type of problems that may be asked in the examination of CAT and in other management entrance examination. Thank you very much.